Hey you guys, and welcome back to That Disney Girl. So this week we're gonna be taking a look at the most coveted room in all of Disney, the Cinderella Castle Suite. Located on the end of Main Street inside of Cinderella's castle, this is one of the most famous rooms that you can ever stay at on Disney property, and it's one that few do get to. So let's take a look at the history of the room, let's go inside and have a tour, and then we're gonna find out how you can stay at Cinderella's Castle Suite. So when Magic Kingdom was being built, Walt wanted a room inside of the park that he could bring his family in that he could stay in while he was visiting. This is much like the room that he had and still has today at Disneyland. But as we know, Walt did pass away before the completion of Magic Kingdom, so this room never came to fruition. Which is something that I always thought was kind of odd. I mean, Walt's family definitely could have still stayed in this room, but like I said, it never happened. So the room that would have been a second home to Walt Disney ended up being a telephone operating booth for the Disney company. I mean, that's an office I would love to work at, but moving on. So the room stayed this way, and then in 2006 we heard that Disney was going to be launching A Year of a Million Dreams starting at the end of that year in October. So Disney was going to complete 1 million dreams, and 307 of those dreams were going to be a one-night stay inside of a Cinderella Castle Suite. So this means that Imagineers only had 6 months to complete all of the Imagineering and detail that would be needed to go into Cinderella's Royal Suite. But how about we take a look inside of Cinderella's Royal Suite? From what I know, Cinderella's castle was inspired by 8 different castles around the globe, and 4 of those castles are actually inside of France. And it's that French architecture and style that comes into the room at Cinderella's Royal Suite. So the suite is actually located right up here on the 4th floor of the castle, inside of these windows. And you get up to the 4th floor by using an elevator, which you get access to by the passageway that is right under the kingdom. So this is the same place where you can go to Cinderella's Royal Table or Bippity Boppity Boutique. I believe if you're walking through Main Street right through the passageway, on the right side, one of those wooden doors with like the cast iron designs on them, that's gonna be a door that opens up to like a little mini lobby for this hotel. And when you go through this door, it's like you've just found this magical little hidden room. The architecture is stunning, there's vaulted ceilings, painting, artwork, crystal everywhere, and there's even a grandfather clock that never strikes midnight, so the magic never has to actually end. It's that level of imagineering that makes me really love Disney. So there's a desk there with a chair, and that's kind of like your concierge, which you do have for 24 hours when you're staying at the suite. And if you look to the right, you will find your elevator that will take you to the 4th floor into your suite. And an interesting thing to note about this elevator was that it was actually imagineered to look like the inside of Cinderella's royal pumpkin that took her to her ball. So when you finally turn that key and walk into the suite, you're kind of entered into a mini lobby of your hotel room. There's a mosaic of Cinderella's carriage on the floor, and it is stunning. It's over 30,000 pieces that are comprised to make this mosaic. And when you look on the walls, you can see Cinderella's glass slipper and other little details that belong to Cinderella, so it feels like you're actually in her room. It is the most immersive room that Disney has ever created, with the highest quality finishes and touches, plus the highest level of Imagineering that I've ever seen go into a Disney room. But if we're talking about the specs of the room, it's actually not too crazy. It's a 650-foot square foot room, it has 2 queen beds, and there's also like a little parlor area which has a couch that can pull out and sleep another 2 people, so in total this room will sleep 6 guests. So although the layout is quite typical, you'll never find another portrait in front of your bed that's Cinderella that also turns into a TV, or a fireplace in your room that's actually shooting out little fireworks behind it. Plus, you can even draw a curtain from the parlor to the main bedrooms, so if you are a larger family and you want some privacy, you can do that. But I think the best part by far of this suite is the bathroom. It has the most elegant double sinks, a gigantic room for your toilet, there is a stunning shower with beautiful mosaic pieces going on along the walls, and then
the bathtub.
Now, I'm a girl who loves her tubs, and this bathtub takes the cake. It's a jetted jacuzzi with lights that can change towards whatever mood you want to feel, and when you're looking at this, I kind of get a Grecian vibe, and I think it's from the architecture and like the poles that are going on. And when you look up, there's going to be a beautiful set of stars that you can look at, so you can dim the lights in the bathroom and really take full advantage of that. There's also beautiful murals on 3 sides of the wall, so that's definitely something you can take a look at. Now, although from the outside of the castle, it looks like there could be a balcony attached to this room, this actually is a balcony that's not intended for the use of guests, and you might think you have a great view from this room, but it is actually a little bit clouded by the stained glass windows that are there. Now, speaking of those stained glass windows, they kind of tell the story of Cinderella as you look at them, And by clouding your vision to the outside, it really enhances the immersion that this suite is meant to entail. And plus, if you want to look outside, you definitely still can. But the windows aren't going to be too big, and this is because of forced perspective, which is something that Walt used in Disneyland, and they use it here on Cinderella's castle. The point of this is to make that castle look even bigger than we think it is, and they do this by creating really large windows and doors on the base of the castle, but as you go up, those windows are going to get smaller and smaller, which make you think that the castle is just getting higher and higher. So by the fourth floor, the windows aren't going to be too grand, but they are still quite large. So when you're staying at Cinderella's Royal Suite, you are going to be escorted there by a guide slash concierge that's going to be with you for the full 24 hours that you're spending at the suite. Or possibly a little bit less than 24 hours depending on when you arrive. If you arrive bright and early in the morning, you can get in there before the park even opens, and while they're preparing your room, you'll have the chance to ride all of the rides with no lines. And if you get there after the park opens, your guide will be like your human fast pass, and he or she will get you on any ride instantly. These guides have a huge knowledge of Disney, so they'll be pointing out and telling you history as you go along, so it's almost like you get a free tour included. Plus, these guides will get you anything you need during your stay. Literally any food you can think of, they will bring to you. I mean, check out this picture of Katy Perry eating a pizza. I haven't read this anywhere, but I think that the point of this is to kind of feel like you have your own fairy godmother with you the whole time. Something that I found interesting was that if you wanted to see the fireworks, you can see them from inside of the room or outside of the room, but you have to decide this beforehand. If you want to see the fireworks from the outside, they will escort you to a really special space on the hub grass, but this has to take place before the fireworks begin. If you're in the room when the fireworks begin, you are not allowed to leave until they conclude. And something that I was always wondering was, when the park's closed, what if you want to go outside of your room? I mean, if you're at a normal hotel, you can wander wherever you want at any time of the day, and I was wondering if it was the same for Disney, and it actually is. So your fairy godmother would kind of accompany you whenever you go inside or outside of your room. You just kind of have to hang out with them, and they have to know where you are at all times, but you can go into the park when there is no one there at 2 in the morning. And then sadly at 7:30 a.m., you're gonna have an early checkout time and you will have to leave the suite. So now that we all wanna stay in the suite, let's find out how you can. Unfortunately, this suite is not up for a price tag. People have offered upwards of $40,000 for the night, and Disney has rejected these offers. The only way to stay in a suite at this point in time is basically to win it. There are many charities that run that Disney offers this room to as a prize for their charity, and sometimes there are even some lucky guests inside the park that might be approached by a cast member and offered a night inside of the suite. But if you want to find the quickest way to get your shot at a room inside of this suite, all you really have to do is Google it. You can find lots of charities that are doing giveaways for the room. But just like a fairy tale, the room picks you. Oh, and I've also heard that there's a World of Dreams tour that will get you a tour of the suite for a mere $12,000 for you and 5 other guests. So if you have that money lying around and this tour is still being offered, then I guess you can buy yourself a visit to the suite. So that's it. If you would love to stay in this room, make sure that you give the video a nice big thumbs up. Leave a comment on what you think about the suite. And make sure to subscribe to this channel for your Disney videos every week. And I will see you real soon. Bye, everyone!